Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the different anatomical planes and some terms that show up in anatomy. Now, the reason I made this video is because I make videos on anatomy and embryology sometimes, and I obviously use the different anatomical terms. They exist for a reason, and that's uniformity, so everyone really understands what someone else is talking about. If you need help understanding what those terms are, or if you want a quick refresher, hopefully with this video I can help you out. To understand any of this, first we need to know the anatomical position. That's the position used for the description of anything in the body. Very simply, the head faces forwards, arms by the side, palms face forward, and feet face forward. So any description of any body part or organ or bone or whatever it is with the subject in this position. The first thing we'll look at are the different planes. So if you've looked at anatomy textbooks or atlases, there are pictures with the kind of section mentioned under them, like sagittal, coronal, transverse sections. These are planes. They're the angle at which these sections are taken, and they're used in medical imaging as well. The sagittal and coronal planes are vertical or longitudinal planes. That's in the direction of head to toe. The sagittal plane goes this way, so it splits the body into a right and a left portion. Now, it doesn't have to be in the midline. Any plane going in this direction is sagittal. If it is in the midline, it's called the median plane. Also called the mid-sagittal plane, because it's in the middle. The planes off-center are the parasagittal planes, but ultimately they're all sagittal planes, where there's a right part and a left part. The coronal plane or the frontal plane is a longitudinal plane as well, so it's in the direction of head to toe, but perpendicular to the sagittal plane. It splits the body into a front part and a back part. Now, we use the terms anterior for front and posterior for back, but I'll get to that when we talk about some of the terms. Again, this plane doesn't have to split it in halves. As long as it goes in this direction, it's the coronal plane or the frontal plane. Sagittal and coronal, they are the longitudinal planes and they're perpendicular to each other. Now we go perpendicular to the longitudinal plane. That's the transverse plane or the horizontal plane. Now this splits the body into an upper part and a lower part. Again, it doesn't have to be in halves. Anywhere in this direction is a transverse plane. Sagittal, coronal, and transverse planes. Those are the three anatomical planes. Now we look at some of the directional terms. Something that may help is that in order to describe something in anatomy, usually it's done in relation to something else. That's what these terms are, and hopefully that'll make sense in a while. The first set of terms we'll use are anterior and posterior. Anterior is the front and posterior is the back, yes. But if we look at this area here, in front we have the sternum and behind we have the vertebral column. The heart is between the two, but the heart is behind the sternum and in front of the vertebral column. So saying the heart is anterior and stopping the sentence there just doesn't make much sense. It's like saying the heart is in front of and then saying nothing more. In front of what? In relation to what? The heart is anterior to the vertebral column and posterior to the sternum. The vertebral column is posterior to the heart and the sternum. So you see, it has to be in relation to another structure. And with practice over time, you'll gain fluency in this language. Another term that's used instead of anterior is ventral, and instead of posterior is dorsal. You'll see these terms more in embryology, but basically ventral is anterior and dorsal is posterior. How I usually remember this is that the D of dorsal is an inverted P, so it's posterior, making ventral anterior. A similar term to dorsal is dorsum. Now this is used for some structures, like the feet. If you look at the feet in anatomical position, they project anteriorly. They have two surfaces, the sole and the back of the foot. The sole is called the plantar surface, but the top of the foot, that's called the dorsum of the foot. Similarly for the nose, there's the dorsum of the nose, because it too projects anteriorly. But here we have anterior and posterior. The coronal plane divides the body into anterior and posterior. The transverse plane divides the body into superior and inferior. Superior is towards the head, so it's also called cranial. And inferior is towards the feet. It's also called caudal. Again, cranial and caudal you'll see more in embryology. Cranial is towards the head end of the embryo, and caudal is towards the tail end. But if we look at superior and inferior, we'll pick up the heart again and put it below the brain. The heart is inferior to the brain, but the brain is superior to the heart. Obviously, this is just in terms of positioning of these organs, but hopefully this helps you out with understanding superior and inferior. Superior is above and inferior is below. Medial and lateral. Now, this is a little more challenging than the previous two sets, but medial is towards the midline, M for M. Lateral is away from the midline. So if we assume this is the midline, then structures closer to it would be medial to the structures that are farther away from it. And those farther away would be lateral to the structures closer to the midline. Let's look at the relationship between the thumb and the little finger. It doesn't matter which hand, because in the anatomical position, the palms face forwards. The little finger is closer to the midline. So the little finger is medial to the thumb, and the thumb is farther away from the midline, making it lateral to the little finger. That's medial and lateral, towards the midline, away from the midline. These terms can be mixed and matched, obviously not within the same group because they're opposites. So supero-inferior would make absolutely no sense. But supero-lateral, or inferomedial, inferolateral, anteroposterior, posterolateral, all this stuff makes sense. Superolateral would be above and away from the midline. Anteromedial would be in front and towards the midline. Like this, terms can be combined. There are a few others, like proximal and distal, which needs a little practice to get the hang of it. But proximal would be closer to the attachment of a limb or a body part, and distal would be away from it. If you look at the lower limb, the femur, that's the thigh bone, which is closer to the attachment of the limb, is proximal to the tibia in the leg. So the tibia would be distal to the femur. There are joints in the fingers and the toes. The joint further away from the attachment of the digit is the distal interphalangeal joint. And closer to its attachment is the proximal interphalangeal joint. That's proximal and distal. Superficial and deep. Now these are easier. Closer to the surface, more superficial. That's why there's superficial fascia and deep fascia, which would be closer to the body cavities. But again, it's relative. Superficial to what? Deep to what? It's how you use those terms in sentences. The last one I'm going to include is laterality. So we know that something farther away from the midline is lateral to something closer to the midline. But if our reference line is in the midline, things can be on both sides, like the hands, or on one side, like the spleen. If you're talking about something on both sides, they are bilateral. Bilateral thumbs, bilateral femurs, bilateral eyes, like that. Unilateral is on one side, like the spleen is a unilateral organ. If you were talking about just one femur, then you'd use the term unilateral. But if something were to happen to the eye on one side and the hand on the same side, that would be ipsilateral. So when you're referring to two different structures on the same side, that's ipsilateral. The eye on one side and the hand on the other side, that's contralateral because we crossed the midline. Different structures across the midline, like the eye and the hand, that is contralateral. But the same structure, like both hands, on both sides of the midline, that is bilateral. Bilateral, both sides. Unilateral, one side. Ipsilateral, same side. Contralateral, opposite sides. Those are all some of the different terms that you'll come across while studying anatomy and medicine. If you find terms like these difficult, don't worry. With practice, it just becomes a part of your language at some point. But I hope this video was a little helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.